Dobar dan svima koji razumiju. And yeah, excited to be here. Well, the project Drowning Neretva River Nature Destruction Trespass Alliance is not only my project. We are a group of people who is working on this research, cross-media research-based project, and I started to work on it with Damir, Ugljen, who is also here somewhere in the public, in 2018 in January. And then Damir is from Mostar and he lives there and also has very strong relationship with the city. I'm actually from Sarajevo, from another city in Bosnia. And also then intermedia artist Matija Kralj joined us to help in documenting our research. And I also taught graduation studio at TU Delft for 1 year on post-traumatic landscapes. And Mostar and Neretva actually was the focus of our research. So that's how Jonas is also part of our project today, and because we are continuing with that. He's in Thailand saying hello, working there now. And actually, we will show just few things about it because it's really big research, I would say, because of the river itself. And we are trying to actually think with the condition that we found there during our research. So I would like to start from this territorial scale. As you can see, like, I don't know how good is this blue line. That's actually, Neretva is long 200 kilometers. It goes from Dinaric Alps all the way to, it flows to Croatia, like the, where is Delta. And we work on these specific three spots that you can see with on the left. Maybe this pointer works, I don't know, yes. And the red squares are actually dams that are on Neretva. So it's really like a changing landscape, productive, natural, wild, destroyed. There are all kind of conditions in this specific locations. On the following video, I will actually show you what is city Mostar famous for, and it's like international spot, very touristic, and the old bridge. I assume half of this room knows about this old bridge, so, and every contemporary narrative, political or not, is related to this specific element of a much more complex city, and everything is actually focusing on that, that element. Also, through this video you can see our research methods, I would say, what kind of work we did, like above the ground mapping, observing, we did archival research, underwater filming. So Damir is archaeologist and diver, and we were lucky, it's a very expensive operation, but we could do it ourselves. And we will show some of these materials that we did also under the water, and this was during the time when we were documenting under the old bridge of Mostar. It's also used as a touristic attraction for divers who are jumping from the bridge. They are paid. And so, yeah, it's a job. Yeah. Okay, so I think this is actually enough. You get the point, what is it about? And actually this specific bridge is kind of related to this narrative of divided city. It's the most, it's the strongest image that Mostar has internationally and locally as well, what is kind of a problem. So this is one of our themes or research methods itself, if you want, like exploration of the hybrid landscapes of the Neretva River in relation to the city of Mostar while documenting explosive and implosive violence on Neretva, as proposed by Bjugn Chulhan in his book Topology of Violence. And we are kind of trying to cover two timelines, not so strictly, but I had to put it there so you can get information on what is it about, actually. So we are looking at the, during the war period between 1992-1995/1996, when military destruction, destructive operations took, happened in Mostar, and that is period that we are calling explosive violence, where actually everything kind of went out of the city, like kind of exploded, materials, objects, people, whatever you want. It was very, how to say, dispersive. And then after the war, when the military violence stopped with the peace agreement, and then but continue to be part of the landscape system in form of spatial or social trauma, and this is what we actually look at forms of implosive violence. And now I would show you what I mean by that in two slides, because there is much more we can also discuss personally or during the questions. So since the first bridge was built in Mostar to connect two sides of the city in 15th century, they always play the role not only of the connection or infrastructure, but kind of social point around the city, an important, part, as a part of the public space, and it was used for all kind of activities, like for learning how to swim, or I don't know, like different, it's very hot in Mostar during the summer, so people would spend a lot of time along the river, sleeping, doing like everyday activities, let's say. Then these transformations actually use of the river, and but also like materiality changed during the first war in Mostar that started in 1992 when Yugoslavia National Army was withdrawing from the city. So the bridges that you see on the right side, there are 9 bridges. They destroyed them. All modern bridges were destroyed in the same time. I don't know how many bridges in the world has opening for explosive, to build explosive inside. So if you need if there is an emergency, if you want to destroy the bridge, it's very easy. You just explode it and then you kind of cut the connections between city. This is always done for military purposes or some other, activities. So this is when the destruction of the bridges started, like in 1992, and then the last bridge was destroyed in 1993. That was the old bridge. This is during the Second World War in Mostar. They have this periodization. It's the only city that has this periodization of war in Bosnia. That was between Croatian and Bosnian side, and this division still exists. And actually, this is the moment when the city became completely disconnected, and I show you the territorial map of the Neretva on purpose because it's a very big river. You cannot just cross it. Like, okay, today I walked over it. It's cold river, it's fast, and then citizens together with army and some other people started to build temporary bridges on different locations to connect just that neighborhoods in between these two parts. And these temporary bridges were used for everything, like this one has a water pipes, for example, also to communicate for wounded people, to bring them to hospital. Like every communication happened through these bridges. And they are still under the water, not all of them, because we take Neretva as a flowing archive. We call it flowing archive, and as it is fast river, I think she brought away a lot of things, but some of them are still there. You can even walk on them under the water. So this is the sketch, just to show you more or less the position between modern, like, or old bridge and these temporary bridges. They were like in between the pre-war bridges. And then also there are some commemorative practices. This is one of the zip lines that was kind of pushed on the other side of the river to transport the people or the goods. So the images and remnants of the bridges in the river are both immaterial and material traces of the everyday life in Mostar, crossing in non-linear way war times, with the pre-war and after the war times, including many agents and respective forms, like human, non-human, the life of animals, plants, and objects, then architectonic in broader sense, urban, fluvial, and geomorphological, like it's really everything is possible to observe in these locations. And also hybrids that were created from this accidental or design encounters. Also, our recent work was around Mostarsko jezero. It's a lake, artificial lake that was kind of dirty around, and the citizens recently cleaned it, like last year or something, to start to use it. But then in September 2018, they found mines under the water in this specific location. So our civil protection units and from Czech Republic, divers came to practice how to demine underwater environments after some military, and also this was the disposal for the mines that were taken from the land mined territories. So they choose river to, so you can imagine how, I mean, it's like a serious environmental disaster. So above the ground, you have people who are like swimming there and having the summer activities or spring, and then you have the mine sign that goes into the water, what is really strange, I would say. And then also we have kind of methodological intent to bring perspectives of post-human theory into architecture and landscape research, relying on the work of Donna Haraway, Rosie Braidotti, but many other authors as well as other concepts as non-standard architecture by Bernard Cachet, or matter memory and geotrauma by Iranian philosopher Reza Negarestani. And as I said, like, we are also having personal relationship with the river. It's, you have to do it because it's kind of, and also how to bring non-human perspective in this kind of research. So I'm writing a lot to the river, let's say, a lot, but yeah. And this is one of the letters I wrote in November, and I will read for you and play you the video that actually shows this underwater research and underwater materials that we found. And what was the name of the person before me? He mentioned like architecture as a medium. We are taking river as a medium. Yeah, well, so we are taking river as a medium to do this research. So I find a lot of resonance with it's nice. Can we lower the light or something? So drowned in Neretva. This is the second time that I'm writing to you. I'm sorry that it took me so long. In my dreams, and not only, I was wondering about your stream bed, organic formations, rocks, plants, animals, and anything aquatic that is related to you. Your underwater world without humans in flesh and blood, but with material traces of their everyday life and achievements that are destroying your ecological balance and proposing new radical environments. Drowned in Neretva, me, you, temporary war bridges, a lot of iron, animals of plastic bags, blankets and wardrobe, more plastic bags, books, Superman, cables, bullets. First time when I wrote to you, I was asking different questions that came to my mind after I was walking on your riverbanks. I was so attracted by the greenish color of your water, by the sound of the water stream. I was carefully observing the shapes of your water flow, immersing my hands and foot in your cold water. I wanted to become you. I wanted to become a river. Instead, my organic transformations have to wait. I noticed that many things changed for you. I also changed. I'm still looking for our relationship, but I don't want to become you anymore. That was my anticipation of your past, excluding explosive and implosive violence on you. Any human attempt to become a river brought you in this environmental danger that you are going through. Forget some parts from my first letter. I'm not interested anymore to know how do you archive all the human materials violently drowned in you as the bullets or mines. But I'm longing to know how do you live with and think with these materials. Finally, and if I think deeper, there is still something important from my first letter that you should know. If I will ever have a daughter, I will call her Neretva. So, this is